What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of American Truck Simulator. This is episode 20. I'm trying to fix my camera or my mouse. Let's see, anybody over there? Yep. On the curb, hit the sign. Nice. So this is a relatively short job for us. We normally do about 700 to 900 miles. We're only doing 548 miles. We were in Carson City and I just couldn't find any jobs out of Carson City that were longer than 300 miles, so I decided to quick travel to Sacramento. And then, so once I got here, there wasn't really that many jobs that were going like south. Like, I wanted to go to like Carlsbad or San Diego or something like that, but there wasn't any jobs going that direction. So I just decided to take Sacramento to Prim, Nevada, and then maybe we'll get something to Carlsbad or San Diego, because I want to drive on the 8. I'm tired of driving on the same roads, like I said previously. We've been on the 40 and the 10, like, a lot. So I want to be, like, on the 8 or something. So maybe when we get to Prim or we can go to Las Vegas or something, and maybe we'll get something to like San Diego or something. Just to get out of the, you know, taking the same route every time. It gets old. Not only for you guys, but for me as well, so. Wrong gear. Come on, truck. So today, not only was it raining, that's a whole other topic with how much I hate traffic, but I'll get into that later. I got in my car and my display that I have, it's a pretty large display. It's like a 5x7. It's not like a DVD player or TV or anything. I mean, you can put like pictures on a flash drive and have them as your like screensaver as you're playing music, but I don't really do that. So, which made me think, I have a flash drive now, but I didn't think to put pictures on it. Anyways, so I have my display in my car. And I turned on my car and everything was blank. I mean, the screen was on, but like, where it said, like, my car's a Chevy, where it says, like, it normally opens up and says Chevrolet and then turns on and then is fine, but for some reason it was all blank. Like, I have XM radio right now as a trial 2 month period, whatever. You know, normally say the title of the song, and I didn't even see that we had to get off here. The title of the song and the time and if your Bluetooth was connected. Whoa. If your Bluetooth was connected or anything like that, but for some reason it wasn't showing up. So I troubleshooted with it for a little while, and then I eventually went on the forums for my car, and they say that's a pretty common occurrence. lately, or not lately, but in the past couple months. So there's a lot of different things that you can go about to fix it, but I just didn't, I just didn't really have the time, because I was on my way to go, going somewhere. So one of the things was to take out the fuse for the radio and leave it out for about 5 minutes with the car off, whatever. So I went to take out the fuse, and as soon as I went to take it out, because I just used my fingers, I didn't use a fuse puller, because I don't know where it was. Maybe I didn't get one in my car, I don't know. I lost the fuse. It like got, it's somewhere in my dash right now. I don't know where it is. So I found a parts, most of the parts store that were around were closed already, which is the other, I mean, the one that really stays open all night long, or all day long, well, till about midnight, is AutoZone. But I wasn't even close to AutoZone, so I ended up going to, I think it was Napa or something like that, and it said it closed in like 15 minutes, and I was about 10 minutes away. And so as I was driving, I hit my blinkers, and there was no noise, so I didn't even know if my blinkers were working. So I got to the place, I ended up getting the fuses, and I put it back in, and it was still the same, and I was like, what the heck? So then I got to where I was going, I turned off the car, made sure the radio was completely off, because sometimes there was, well, they were saying on the forums that sometimes it'll stay on and drain your battery, but it turned off. And then when I got in my car about, well, not got in my car, when I was on my way, let me roll back, before I got to where I was going, it said, do you want to reset the radio? And I said, yeah. So I pushed continue, and then it went back to normal, and then it immediately turned off, and I was like, oh crap. And then my blinkers stopped making the ticking sound, and I was like, great, back to where I was. Luckily I got about 5 fuses, but I'm back to where I was. So by the time I got to my destination, it turned back on and it was completely fine. So I'm gonna have to see with, you know, if I turn it on tomorrow, if it's still messed up. If it's still messed up, I'm just gonna have to go to Chevy and have them fix it or replace it, because I still have a warranty. And then earlier today, I went to the doctor, and I was on the freeway, and it was pouring rain, and I heard a rock hit my window. And I mean, anybody that drives a car, you know, when you know when that happens, you can hear it. It's pretty loud. Well, it's kind of loud. I didn't think anything of it, and I got in my car tonight after letting it sit for about 4 hours, and it just, I saw something, like, every time I went through, like, well, underneath a light, as I was looking at my windshield, I could see, it was either a crack or like a spider web, and I'm like, okay, so I'm gonna put up my windshield wipers and see what that is. And turns out the crack is about almost a foot long, and it's like gonna be in my way pretty soon, so I gotta get a new windshield. I have insurance. I only have to pay like $70, I think, copay. I've already received a windshield. I mean, I've already gotten a windshield with it. Well, last year around Christmas time, I got a windshield because it got cracked. So I got to call my insurance company probably tomorrow, just so they can get the claim ready, so I can go ahead and go and get a new windshield before it becomes a problem or gets in my way or I don't know. So that was a kind of a downer. That and my radio. I didn't notice the, I mean, I heard it earlier, the rock hit my windshield. I didn't really think anything of it. And then as it got colder and then I turned on my car with the defroster and I just saw it start to kind of move. And I was like, great. Anytime it's cold, you turn on the heat, the crack will just start to just get bigger and bigger. And as you hit bumps in the road. Luckily I have insurance or windshield insurance because this happens a lot in California. Obviously, if it's already happened to me once. Well, it happened to me last Christmas. So I've gone about a year and a month happened again, or it's happening again. So that kind of sucks. But I'll get it replaced here. And whoa, dude. I'll get it replaced in probably a couple days. Doesn't take my insurance that long. It's just really about when the windshield place has time. Or when I have time. Doesn't take that long. Probably takes about an hour. Safe light repair, safe light replace. And then it's been raining for the past 3 days. And I've been driving to all my doctor's appointments. And people are just dumb. They'll be in the fast lane, number one lane, going like 40 miles an hour. Like, get over 5-6 lanes to the slow lane and go 40 miles an hour. I ain't supposed to go 40 on the freeway. If it's not like, if there's no traffic, you gotta keep up with everybody else. It's just people that are driving right now, where I live, or probably all around wherever it rains, they, you know, there's those people that just don't know how to drive in the rain. All you gotta do, slow down a little bit. Or, I don't really slow down that much, but, you know, but keep some distance between you and the car in front of you and there'll be no problems. Just in case you gotta stop him fast. So many accidents. You look at, like, when it's raining and you go to the, like, Google Maps and you just look at, you know, right as it starts raining and just, instead of it being green, like, traffic is good, it's red everywhere. Doesn't matter what time of the day it is. It's just red everywhere because nobody knows how to drive. Everybody's like, as soon as, like, a droplet hits the windshield, they're like, instant brakes. Like, if the speed limit's 70, you go like 60 or 65. I go the same speed, but it's hard to go the same speed when everybody else around me is going like 40. You can't go 40. That's just asking to be rear-ended or to be hit or to be rear-ended, whatever, either way. But like I said in previous episodes, I can go on and on about traffic. I feel like they're just giving away licenses to people. Like, not even doing the test. I mean, the test hasn't changed. The driving test has not changed. Well, at least in my town. It's been the same for years. All you gotta do is drive around. They put you on the, they don't even take you on the freeway. They put you on the, like, this highway that's 55, and you go 55, and then you go down a couple surface streets, and then they take you to this area in which you gotta parallel park. Once you parallel park, it's over. It's like a 5-minute driving test. They should take you on the freeway. That would be really good. make sure you know how to get on to the freeway, keep up with traffic, merge, use your turning signals. Don't drive with your turning signal on the entire time, like this. Just annoys me. But what brought that up was that my traffic rant was it's been raining for the past 3 days in Southern California, so and I've been driving, so I just noticed a lot of people. Like, people drive, like, super close to semis, and you can't even see, like, if you're, like, if that car in front of me is a semi and I'm a car behind it, you can't even see anything because all the water that's coming off the tires. You gotta have, like, your windshield wipers on full blast. You slow down a little bit, or you get in another lane. But you still gotta maintain, like, you still gotta give, like, a, probably about this far of a distance. Just to give yourself, well, that's pretty far right there, but. Like, where that truck is about now. Like, 3 or 4 or 5 car lanes. I'll say 5 car lanes, just in case. And then, dumbasses. Well, sorry about my language, but dumbasses will come in and they'll pull right in, they'll like cut right in front of you and you gotta slam on the brakes. Makes me angry. So, but anyways, back to the game. I updated Jazzy Cat mod, traffic mod. It's now, I mean, all the cars look the same, but it's now 1.7.1. It used to be 1.6.1. I took that one out, put in 1.7.1. They said some cars changed. I haven't really noticed. Maybe you guys have as I've been talking, but I haven't noticed any new cars anyways. And getting off here. This way, look this way, nobody's over there, there's a car coming, I think. No? Nope. Don't do it, pal. Did I hit him? I don't know. I don't think so. So basically, I changed my... instead of having to like turn like this on all the way back, I changed it to go like this and like this, so that it's a lot quicker, you know. So that I'm not waiting, so I'm not like, I mean, that came, that's the buttons I had before. I mean, I still have the buttons, but it just seemed kind of slow. When I can easily just push 4 and 6. 4 is left, 6, and then 8 is middle, but I still gotta move it over. And then I changed. The buttons that I was talking about, L3 and R, L3, L2, R3, and R2. I changed them all to do something. is that not for parking? I should have a list, like, on my monitor or near my monitor, so I know which buttons are for what. But I just was tired of hitting L3 on accident and it going to the menu screen, so I changed it to do, like, trailer brake or parking brake or something like that. I changed a few of them around. Whoa, crash. I knew that much. Instant brakes. Good job, pal. Oh, now you're gonna go in the red light. Nice. That's great. So I think... yeah. So I made R3 is trailer brake so that I could test. I mean, you don't really got to test it in this. I was thinking about it because I always watch all my videos after I record them. You know how they have like battery and oil and all that stuff. I wish that, I mean, I know I service my truck all the time. Well, I'm gonna have to service it now, but, well, I only got 2% damage, but it's gonna be a lot more. I wish that certain things happened when it comes to driving. Like, because you always see trucks broken down on the side of the road. Tire blowouts. I wish there was, you know, tire blowouts and, you know, dead batteries and, you know, just normal stuff that happens with trucks. But instead of being, like, towed somewhere, like, a truck would come and, you know, give you a new battery or give you, you know, kind of like how they do in real life. Or a truck would come and change your tire, or you can decide if you want to be towed to a service center, whatever. That'd be pretty cool. Like if, you know, air pressure lines snapped or, you know, certain things like that. Temperatures too high. Like just stuff that happens in real cars or real trucks. Here's a dually that we haven't seen in a long time. Dodge, Ram. I sold my truck by Aradeth, and I bought a W900. I don't know if I told you guys that, but. So I have a 389 Peterbilt 389. I have a 579. I have a W900, and I want to get the other Kenworth, the newer Kenworth. I want to drive it. I haven't driven it. The newer body style. I've been looking for mods for trucks, but I just can't find anything I like. They're always like way out there as far as, you know, like who designed this thing? Like it's, the truck is like the size of the trailer. It's like a, well, almost the size. It's like a 40-foot truck. It's got like, it's like a four axle, and then the sleeper is like, well, a little lag there. The sleeper is like humongous, and it's like, how do you even drive that? I mean, driving it by itself is a challenge. I can't imagine having a trailer on the back of it. But they do have some Mack trucks that I like, but they're older. They also have a 2018 Cascadia, I think it's called. It's like a, looks like a futuristic truck. That truck that just passed going the other direction is the truck I basically got. It's got an aero on the top, aerodynamic thing on the top, W900. If we see another one, I'll point it out. Or if you just go backwards in the video, you'll see it. It's the white one. Or at the end of this video, I'll show you it. If I remember. So what I was talking about when I got off topic, the trailer brake, before I started talking about all the instrument panel, the trailer brake is basically, you do like a tug test, is what trucks would normally do. They put the trailer brake on and then they hit the gas and to see if it's connected or not, to see if the truck's connected, but the truck is automatically connected. It's not like we can be driving and, well, not in this game, I don't think, unless you push the button to release the trailer, for the trailer to just snap off and you leave it behind without even knowing if you don't look in your rearview mirrors. I gotta go straight. Sorry, buddy. I'm trying to get better at driving this thing. You know, I was telling you guys a couple episodes ago how I'm trying to get better at shifting, not being so quick, and you guys being able to hear me shift, as well as maintaining my lane going around corners so that other trucks or cars can pass, because normally I'm in the other lane when I'm going around a corner. Any turn, really, my truck is normally in the other lane. Miles. Then I believe I made, oh yeah, I think I already said this. I think I made L3 cruise control. Let me see. I did. L3 is now cruise control instead of it going to the menu. I was gonna get over, but I can't. Yeah, L3 is cruise control, L2 is trailer brake. I mean, not trailer brake, retarder, or engine brake. That is my trailer brake, which I could probably use to slow down. Let me see. Yeah, does slow. So I can use that to slow down. Well, now I know. I can use that to slow down as well as the brakes in the truck. just in case I gotta slow down immediately. Well, that's if I remember to do that. I don't always remember. It always happens so fast that, like, that one guy at the light that I rear-ended. I find myself, when I'm out, I don't go looking for them, but I find myself lately, like if I go to the doctor or something, or if I go to the store, and I see a truck backing up, I'll stop and watch them. Kind of creepy, but it's like airplane watching. Well, that's what I compare it to, so I don't sound like a creep. Like, people like railroad stuff, they'll watch trains go by for that half a second that it goes by. They get all, they'll get all excited, like the YouTube video, I think it's called Train Guy. Oh my god, that's a blah 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 blah. And he gets all can't do it now. I was gonna stop and sleep, but we have plenty of time. 8 hours. 10 hours remains on the job. So when it's a job, when it's that's around or anything under 16 hours. So if we would have stopped and slept, we would have missed. Darn it. I wanna get over for these guys, but there's always a car on my left-hand side. If we would have stopped and slept, we would have went way over our time. So I'm glad I didn't. I'm glad I checked it. So when it's not that far of a job, you're supposed to make it. So I don't understand the mod now that if you put in the 9 hours of sleep, how you would. Or 9 hours of driving before you have to sleep, that would kind of mess up when you're supposed to arrive. Because on this job, I would have to sleep, because I've already driven for 9 hours. And 9 hours remains, so I would have slept for about 8 hours. Wow, I'm going fast. I would have slept for 8 hours and had like an hour and 45 minutes to get to my job, which is possible. An hour and 25 minutes. But it's cutting it pretty short. I was gonna play this game off camera on another profile, but I decided to, I decided to go out instead of hanging out at home tonight, or last Friday night. Like, I'll go out. I was pretty tired. I went to the doctor. Before I went to the doctor, I only got like 5 hours of sleep, and then I went to the doctor. Like I said, it's really hard to flip over my sleeping schedule, but I'm good until next week, and then I got another appointment in the middle of the week. So what is it? Yeah, it's that one. I'm gonna try my trailer brake and braking when I get off on the next exit. I didn't think my headlights were on. Seemed kind of not as bright. Prim discovered. Yeah, get out of my way. So I don't know what Jazzy Cat made different. As far as the cars go, they all look the same to me. There's the Avalanche, the BMW. Avalanche. Cop car. Nissan. I think that one's different. Frontier. You know what I really enjoy? They got rid of that Ford Ranger, I believe. I haven't seen that thing in a couple episodes. Or maybe since 1.5 came out. Yeah, because on my last profile, I was talking about how I hate it. Such an ugly looking truck. Lowered and looked funky. Whoa. So let's see. Am I getting off here? What's happening? I am. A weird little. Oh yeah, that really does slow down your vehicle. Nope. Is that telling me that I'm going into a 30 mile an hour zone? Alright. Pull up a little bit. Lots of traffic. I like the different cop vehicles. Each state has different color ones. Nothing. Little bit. A car. Oh, great. That was supposed to be my opportunity, I think. Wait here forever. This does happen in real life, though. Truckers wait forever. I don't know what that guy's doing. I don't know what those people are doing. I'm not in the way at all. I might have to take advantage of this and just go for it. Sometimes. Whoa, sorry, dude. Didn't see you there. That was my bad. I was tired of waiting. I know truckers wait forever, but at some point, just gotta go. See, now you guys can see when I shift, I shift into neutral and then gear instead of just doing it really quickly. Instead of doing it so fast you can't even see, I'm going. Screw it. Before it was like so fast. You couldn't even see neutral at all. I'm working on it. Doesn't happen overnight. except when I'm getting on the freeway, I tend to shift up faster. Let's see if I can do it here. I gotta turn up here anyways. See, a lot more smooth, refined, than being like... It's just when I'm downshifting that I have the problem. I tend to go into too high of a gear, or too low of a gear, and then it revs up too much. But my foot, the reason I'm not like over revving it that much anymore is because I'm not fully putting my foot on the gas, like all the way down. It's like halfway. Where are we going? Back there? Taking the back roads? Then we gotta somehow make a U-turn into this facility? This facility? This Walmart? So we're basically in Las Vegas, right across the freeway. Nobody. See how the map auto, it does like a backwards thing for some reason. I don't know why it does that. Tells me to basically go out the way I came in, and then I don't know where it wants me to go, but I know where I'm supposed to go. Flashers. Parking lights. See where we're going. Probably between these trucks here. Yep. Reverse. No, I don't want three. I don't want four. I don't want four. There we go. Let's just see if we're even close. We're not. Gotta move up more. Not that much, so. I feel that in the steering wheel. We're way off. I need to command this in a different manner. What am I gonna do here? I had to turn it around. Cause I don't think we're even close. Yeah. We're nowhere near close. Jackknife it. Hope to not hit anything over here. That's awfully close. That's hitting it. What about if I... Hold on. What about if I... That looks close. I'll go with it. That pallet. I'm trying to turn my truck around is the problem I'm having at the moment. Jackknife. That's a rail. It's about to flip over. If it was a shorter trailer, I could easily pull in. What is that? What is it doing? Oh, it's jackknife. That's why it's doing that. Parking lights are bugging me. Weird. Parking lights, reverse lights, reverse flashers. This is gonna be fun. That's what I get for picking a 53-foot trailer. Let's just see how, which one. I think it's between, yeah. The two refrigerator ones. Let me see how far off I am. Well, that's not bad, sort of. Let's see here. Problem is, I can't see. Trying to see the, sorry, I know you can't hear me now. I was trying to see the trailer. Oh, that's bad. Really? I don't know why I keep it right there. Just how far am I away from the other trailers? Question. Not that far, because I hit it. Concentration is real. See what that looks like. Out of gear. Wrong button. Pretty good. I'll take it. How much good work? good work. 551 miles, 11 hours, 48 minutes, 104.8 gallons, 1.1% damage, minus 52 XP. That's not bad. Well, because we have all this other stuff on. Bonus parking, fragile cargo, long distance. I know fuel economy isn't like the best thing. Well, for me, I always talk about how I didn't want to do it in my last episode or my last career. I don't even know when I need headlights. I always talked about how I didn't want to do it. Oops. Not that many episodes ago. So now we can do the takeoff paint, the Navy tribute. That one's pretty cool. I like the color. And that one's cool too. Independent. Pretty cool. These I don't like too much. They're kind of, they probably look better on a newer truck than, because they go back here on these, only on these rims. Not too much of a fan of that. But let's go get gas. Let's go over here and discover that dealership. And then we can sleep over here. I can't go that way though, I don't think. This is a no left turn thing, I think. Or maybe it, I don't know. Oh, I think it's fine right there. That's kind of weird. How you can go up to like right here and then you can't go because that's a freeway. See, this is how I drive when I'm going to get gas and I want to record another video. I just avoid everything. Just nope, I don't see you, red light. I don't see nothing. This is what you don't see me doing. This is how crazy I am when I drive. I fuel up. Oh, it's a Volvo dealership. Weird. I put gas. I don't look. I discovered Volvo, weird. I come over here. I thought I already discovered Volvo. Well, at least in Vegas. I service my truck. I check to see if I like anything. Or is this the W900? Wait a second. I don't know. Oh, it is? No, it's a Peterbilt. I don't know. So I still have the Christmas ones. That one looks pretty cool. I'll keep my other one. Which one was it? This one? Or was it black? was just black. We can get rims. Dynamic. I think that looks better. Even though they're not chrome. What about this? Yeah, no. I'll go with the dynamic. And I think that's it. So this is the other grill that comes with it, and I don't like it. I think it looks too new. So I like this one instead. And then we can put on like just that one. It has the lights on it. That's too much chrome for me. And then I like the ones that are painted. Cabin lights. Co-drivers. See, these are, I think they're for ETS, European Truck Simulator. Do I have that? Yeah, not a fan of that. No. Negative. So I just confirmed my order. I don't really spend that much time in it, but let me just go over here real quick. Parking brake, engine off, outside view, my lights off. Not that many lights on it. Actually, I thought I had lights on the sides. Maybe I got rid of them. Well, I gotta do that in editing. I mean, in when I'm not recording, put the lights back on the sides. But anyways, I want to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Take care.